ओके सो आई थिंक देयर इज वन डिवीजन, किसको बीच वाले इस समय, डिवीजन सी और डी, टेल मी।
इट्स सी सर।
सी
ए
सी को इट्स नॉट विजिबल सर।
यस ऑफ कोर्स, बिकॉज वी आर यूजिंग टू इन अ सेम टाइम, टू डिवीजन इन अ सेम टाइम, दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम, ओनली वन डिवीजन कैन सी मी। No problem, but I think whatever I'm going to present over there, that will be visible to you all. Okay, so again, good afternoon to you all, and most welcome in MGM CET for engineering career. I hope,
thank you, sir.
Yeah, I hope you all will enjoy the lecture for basic electrical engineering. It will be very, very interesting subject and total conceptual subject. I already told in your orientation program, if you know the concept, this subject will become very easy to you. But if you are not able to get the concept, the same subject will be very difficult to you all. So I am telling you before starting the lecture that practice well for this subject. If you are doing practice, definitely this subject will be very easy to you all. But if you are not practicing well, that will create a problem to you. Why I am telling this? Because from last 5 years, what I am experienced over there, this is happening actually. Whenever you are going for this particular subject, you miss the concepts and you are not able to get the pass. So anyhow, your target should be all clear for first semester. I am every year I am suggesting for all the students that your target should be you have to pass anyhow. Okay, so I hope you will got the point what I am going to explain over there. Everyone, during the lecture, you have to mute your own self. If you have any doubt regarding the topic, regarding any point, you have to unmute yourself and then you can ask. Okay, I hope this is for it. Now I am going to present a PPT for you. This is a first lecture and we are doing a new thing for this two division in a same time. So maybe a little bit difficulty over there for a starting 5 minutes. So let me know either you are able to get my PPT or not whenever I will ask. Wait a minute. Tell me, students, either my PPT is visible to you or not.
Yes, sir, okay. It's visible. Yes, sir.
Yeah, once again, once again, anyone from C division, is it visible or
yes.
not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay. Anyone for D division, it is visible or not? Tell me. Okay. So I think if you have any doubt regarding that PPT is visible or not, you have to check your internet, because most of the students are having they are not having any problem regarding this PPT. This is visible to you. Okay. So now I'm going to explain what is the basic electrical engineering. With your scheme, when the subject is changed, what the content is changed, what is the use of this subject, what are the applications of this subject, what are the outcomes of this subject, what are the objective of this particular subject, what are the lectures we are going to take for this particular subject, how many lectures are required, what we will discuss in a lecture wise lecture, everything I will explain on this particular lecture. Then we will go slowly for our topic, that basically. So I hope you will enjoy. Let's start our first lecture for basic electrical engineering, that is a BEE. Initially, at 2015, its name was BEE itself, but full form was basic electrical and electronics. Then its name is changed in 2016, that basic electrical engineering. Now itself, its name is basic electrical engineering, but content is changed. So what the content is changed and why they will change, why they change this content, I will explain. First of all, I am presenting you a scheme with which scheme the syllabus is designed and how many numbers we are required for this particular subject. Okay, so look, this is our scheme. So this code of our subject, this is important. What is the code of this subject? This code of this subject is FEC 105. The name of the subject is basic electrical engineering. We are required 3 hours in a week. I know this is a very less, but anyhow, we have to complete the syllabus according to 3 hours in a week. But if it is not possible, we will try to take some extra lectures and we will bind our syllabus in an entire extended way. So I hope we will finish all the syllabus. And what is the scheme for examination? So in our college, or I think in Mumbai University, there is a pattern that you have to give a 2-unit test. All the unit tests are carrying 20 marks. And at the last, you have to take the average of both two tests. Suppose for test one, you are getting some X marks, and for test two, you are getting Y marks. So at the last, you have to take the average of X and Y, and the marks, but what is the average of X and Y, that will be out of 20. This is Z, for example. So whatever the number of marks you are getting in unit test one and two, you have to take an average, that is out of 20. And at the end semester, you have an exam for 80 marks. So out of 80, whatever the marks you are getting, that you add with this, getting average of internal assessment. So that means total BEE is theoretical way you are having 20 plus 80 marks paper, that is for 100 marks. So out of 20, you are required 8 minimum marks for passing, and out of 80, you are required 32 minimum marks for passing. So I hope 8 plus 32, that is equal to 40, that you will get out of 100 for passing. So your target should be there that you should get minimum 40 marks out of 100. Otherwise, you will fail. I'm starting with the fail word because you know the key of success, that you have to think what is the worst case. So worst case, if you are not getting 40 marks. Okay, I hope you all will get more than 70 marks out of 100. That will be achievement for you. Okay, so I hope this is enough for the scheme. Now, what is the objective of this particular subject that I'm going to explain? Please, one notification to you, please mute yourself. Everyone, please mute yourself. Your sound is distracting to me. Okay, yeah. Now, we have to move with the objective and outcomes. What are the objective of this subject? That means if you are going to somewhere, so you should think what we have to do, what we are going to do. That we have to know. So if we are going for a basic electrical engineering, so what we are going to learn for this particular subject? What is the DC? Because we are going to study about DC and AC. So what are the applications of DC and AC? Partholia, huge kahan par karenge? That is the important thing for us. So we have to know where we can apply this basic electrical engineering, that is called objective. So what are the objectives are there? First objective, to provide knowledge of fundamental of DC circuit and single phase AC circuits and its application. Means you know how, what is the DC circuit and what is the AC circuit, but where we can apply, that is very important thing to learn, that we will go to learn in this particular subject. Then if we are talking about second objective, to include knowledge of the basic operation and performance of single phase transformer. Means along with the DC and AC, we have to know what is the transformer and where we are using the transformer. That is the important thing for you, that we have to know. Okay. So anyone is there who is not joined till now? Yes, okay. Once again, it's a notification to you. I think it is audible to you all. I am sending a link in your chat box. You all are listening. I am sending a link in your chat box according to your division, like division C and division D. You have to open that link and mark your attendance. I am getting your attendance directly from this with the software, but you have to mark also. So I am sending you a link. Please open your own link for division C and D. Write P in front of your name. That's you have to do. Just write P in front of you. Okay. Raj Pawar, it is audible to you? Okay, so I'm sending the link first, then we will start our lecture. How are you? Raj Pawar, are you from division C or D? D, okay. So I sent the link for division C. Are you found? Anyone tell me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Wait a second, I'm posting for division D also. So division D, I posted your attendance sheet. Can you find this? Yeah. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Okay. So mark your attendance and mute yourself. Now I'm going to start our lecture. Okay. Yes.
Sir, the sheet is view only. How to mark the attendance?
Just open the link. You will get your attendance sheet. Just write a P in front of you.
No, sir. Sir, we cannot edit it. It's view only option. You'll have to give access to make us be able to edit it.
Sir, attendance mark नहीं हो रहा.
हाँ लिखते नहीं आ रहा उस पे.
Tell me, is it opening or not?
No.
Yeah, Disha, tell me.
No, sir.
I will check. The first lecture, so some difficulty will come in the picture because we are combining two branches. So I think you are using mobile, so it's automatically you are having Google Sheet. If you are not having, so you have to download, yes. So.
No, sir. See, it says view only. You have to change it to edit.
Okay. One second.
Yeah. Yes.
And now you can. Now you can.
No, you'll have to give access to us.
Yeah. Wait a second. I already given, but it's an internet problem is there. One second. Now it's open, but it's again showing view only. I think now it's opening.
No, sir, the one who made the file will have
I
to
already,
give access.
yeah, of course, I give the access, but it is not happening. Na? I already give. Na? One second. Actually, I done this. One, wait a second, I will do no problem. Leave the attendance for this particular lecture. You do your own self if it is possible. I'm going to present the PPT. So please focus on that. Okay. Okay. Now please mute yourself, everyone. Yes. So what are the objectives basically for basic electrical engineering? So we know whenever we go through with the DC circuit, AC circuits, so where we can use that we have to know. And what we are going to learn about transformer also, so that is a single phase transformer. So we have to know where we have to use the single phase transformer. Transformer is itself one subject in electrical engineering department, that we are having a single phase transformer and a three phase transformer. You know, in a transmission line, distribution line, everywhere we are using transformers. Transformers is basically which can transfer our energy from higher potential to the lower potential or lower potential to the higher potential. Means it will not change the power, it just change our voltage level or current level. Either it can increase the voltage level or it can decrease the voltage level. Vice versa, current will change. If voltage is increasing, current will reduce. If current is changing or increasing, your voltage will reduce. This is the concept of transformer. In case of transformer, basically, whenever we will study module number 3, that is a, module number 3, that is a transformer, I will explain everything. In case of transformer, frequency should be constant. We know in India, we are using 50 Hertz frequency. So that should be constant and power should be constant. Power should be constant whenever we are transferring our power from one place to another place by the use of transformer. But what are you going to change? Voltage and current. If voltage is increasing, current will reduce because power is product of voltage and current. So if power is constant, so if one digit is increasing, like voltage is increasing, so definitely current will reduce. This is the concept of transformer. Now, to provide knowledge of fundamental DC and AC machine, basically in basic electrical engineering subject, we are not having as much as time that we are go in detail about DC machine and AC machine. In our syllabus, a DC machine is given only for 2 hours and AC machine is only for 2 hours. So, you know, 2 hours is not sufficient to explain the construction and working itself, because how it's the start, what is the concept we are going to use, Faraday law, what are the different law which we are using in case of any type of machine, either it is a DC machine and AC machine. But anyhow, we have to know little bit knowledge, either we are from computer engineering department, IT department, chemical, mechanical, civil, any other than electrical department, then also you have to know about DC and AC machine fundamentals. Why? Aap bol sakte hai, I'm computer engineer, what is the requirement of the machines? You know, if you are going in a robotics part, means if you are designing a software and you want to install in any robot, so you have to know which type of machine they are using. Either they are using DC machine or AC machine, either induction machine, synchronous machine. A lot of machines are there. So which machine they are going to use? And if they are using a particular machine, so what is the function of that machine? Means what is the rotation of that machine? What is the poles are there? What is the role of poles? So many things you have to know, either you are any type of engineer other than electrical department. That's why in basic electrical engineering, they are introduced a little bit knowledge of DC as well as AC machines. Everyone is note that time is not permitting that we can explain each and everything about the machines for all the students, but basics are required for all. Then these are the objectives with, of basic electrical engineering, and what are the outcomes? You know, nowadays, whatever the college is there, whatever the university is there, everyone is designing our course according to the outcomes. एनी कमिटी विजिटेड इन द कॉलेज फॉर एग्जाम्पल एमबीए नैक एवरी वन वॉन्ट्स दैट वॉट इज द आउटकम ऑफ यूर टीचिंग वॉट इज द आउटकम ऑफ यूर लर्निंग दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग मीन्स इफ यू आर स्टडिंग अ पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट दैट इज द बेसिक थिंग सो After completing each and every module, at least you have to know about that particular module. That's why entire syllabus is designed according to the outcomes. So our education system, it's changed from conventional way to outcome-based learning. So always you will heard about this particular name that is called outcomes. So everywhere, आप कंपनी में भी जाएंगे इफ यू वांट टू गो इन एनी पर्टिकुलर सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनी हार्डवेयर कंपनी दे वांट आउटकम्स फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग आप क्या कर रहे हैं उसमें को आउटकम चाहिए डजंट मीन यू आर डूइंग अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स बट यू आर नॉट गेटिंग एनी आउटकम्स सो दैट्स व्हाई एवरीथिंग इज चेंज्ड नाउअडेज इन द टर्म्स ऑफ आउटकम्स सो व्हाट आर द आउटकम्स सो ऑलवेज इफ वी आर हैविंग सिक्स मॉड्यूल we are having six outcomes so every module is having at least one outcome so look first outcome if we are talking about that is the apply various network theorems so aapko kya karna hai aapko theorems ke bare mein seekhna hai so what are the theorems means you know if you want to find a current from a particular circuit kisi ek circuit mein agar current chahiye aapko what you will do you can apply your ohm's law You know the Ohm's law, I equal to V upon R. So you can get the current. But you know, if you are having a large circuit, you are not able to get that current with the use of Ohm's law itself. So for that, we are using different kinds of theorems. So we are having like mesh analysis, nodal analysis, super mesh, super node, KVL, KCL. We are having superposition theorem, Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem, maximum power theorem. That is in your syllabus. Other than this, we are having Melgen's theorem, Telgen's theorem, and a lot of theorems are there. So we have to learn about the theorems. How we will apply that particular theorem for finding current from a given circuit. So that is our first outcome means we have to learn about different kinds of theorems next second evaluate the analysis of single phase circuits you know we are having single phase as well as a three phase so if we are having a single phase how we can evaluate that means how we can get the current value voltage value power in a particular branch किसी भी अगर कोई भी एक सर्किट है और किसी एक जगह पे आपको करंट पूछेगा या वोल्टेज पूछेगा सो दैट यू हैव टू एबल टू फाइंड आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू विद दिस पर्टिकुलर बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट तो अगर आप ये सब्जेक्ट पढ़ रहे हैं तो पढ़ने के बाद क्या आपको आना चाहिए एटलीस्ट यू हैव टू नो हाउ टू अप्लाई द थ्योरम्स यू हैव टू नो हाउ टू एनालाइज दैट सिंगल फेज सर्किट Likewise, how we can analyze a three-phase circuit, that is our third outcome. Then, fourth one, understand the construction feature of single-phase transformer, which I already explained, that after going through this subject, जब subject finish हो जाएगा, तो आपको मालूम होना चाहिए कि how we can operate a single-phase transformer, where we can use that single-phase transformer, ये हमको मालूम होना चाहिए. Then if we are talking about illustrate the working principle of three phase machine I know it is not possible to explain the three phase machine in a basic electrical engineering subject because time is not permitted but instead of we have to know at least working of three phase machine
हेलो
सर लैग हुए क्या बन हुए
यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल सर
सर गायब नॉट ऑडिबल
सर लैग हो गए
everything, but I'm not seeing you, that either you are joining or not. Okay, mute yourself, everyone. Everyone, mute yourself. Everyone, please mute yourself. Raj Pawar, mute yourself. Yes. Sorry for the disturbance. Actually, an internet problem was there. It should not be happen, but it will happening. Actually, I can't do anything. Okay. So I'm presenting again. Can you tell me where I was when the internet was disconnected? Anyone can tell me.
What, sir?
Sir, we was at the fifth point.
Okay. Yeah. One second. Yes. Sure. Yeah. So I explain these all things actually, but I have to go back. Okay, so I hope it is audible to you all. Yes, okay. So in case of outcomes, basically we have to know about the different type of theorems, like Thevenin theorem, superposition, Norton, maximum power theorems, mesh analysis, nodal analysis, then many more theorems are there which we have to know. We have to know the calculations of single phase AC circuits, like finding the current value, finding the RMS value, average value, and many more things we have to calculate. We have to know about the three phase AC circuits, like we have to know the star connections, delta connections, the current in case of star, current in case of delta, what is the relation between star and delta, in case of resistance, in case of voltage, in case of current, that we have to learn in case of three phase AC circuits. And according to that university, we have to know about single phase transformer, where we are going to use single phase transformer, how we can apply, where we have to apply. These all things we have to take care for this particular subject. Next, we have to know about the three phase machine and single phase machines. We know we are not having as much as time that we have to cover entire thing in case of three phase machine and single phase machine, but at least we have to know about the operation. We have to know at least operation for three phase and single phase, because if you are either computer engineer, civil engineer, mechanical engineer, other than electrical engineer, any one departments you are having, you have to know the basics of machines. Because if you are going to use any robotics, any software, want to install in a particular robot, so you have to know which type of machine you are going to use. If you are not knowing about the machine, you cannot design the software. So instead of you are a software engineer, but you have to know the basic concept of any machines. So these all six things we have to know after learning this particular subject. I hope most of the things I will cover in the lecture, and you will get whatever the things which is required according to the university syllabus. Okay, now I'm going to explain the syllabus. What are the syllabus we have to cover in this basic electrical engineering? What are the prerequisites which is required before starting this particular lecture? And what are the topics which are required for self-study according to the Mumbai University syllabus? So moving with this, once again, I have to remove this because I already explained these all things without seeing either internet is there or not. Okay. Okay. So I have to see again and again either internet is working or not, otherwise. Yes, it.
Sir, बहुत lag हो रहा
है. Anyone else is having this type of problem, lagging problem? Because Yeah, if individual you are having any problem, I think you have to come in the network, because if internet is connected in my PC, so it will it is having 100 Mbps speed, so lagging problem will not be there from my side. Either disconnected, then only the problem come in the picture. If it is connected, the problem will not come because we are having 100 Mbps speed. Okay, so I hope it is audible to you all. Now I'm going to present the syllabus. So before starting basic electrical engineering, we have to know the basic concepts, that is called prerequisite. Means BEE पढ़ने से पहले क्या क्या आपको मालूम होना चाहिए. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स विच यू हैव टू नो बिफोर एंटरिंग द बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट. फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड रेजिस्टेंस, इंडक्टेंस एंड कैपेसिटेंस. सो व्हाट आर द बेसिक डिफरेंस रेजिस्टर, इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. स्टूडेंट्स और समटाइम्स दे आर नॉट एबल टू एनालाइज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रजिस्टर एंड रजिस्टेंस, इंडक्टर एंड इंडक्टेंस, capacitor and capacitance. So you should know that RLC, which is represented over there, that is called a resistor, inductor and capacitor. The value of resistor, inductor, capacitor is called resistance, inductance and capacitance. Got it, everyone? Now, if we are talking about resistance, so we know resistance equal to R equal to rho L by A. A is the length of that particular material which is by which the resistor is made. Area means this is called cross-sectional area of that particular resistance. Okay. Now, if we are talking about inductance, so inductance is represented by XL. So always you have to make a differentiation between inductor and inductance. If inductor value is given, that is always in Henry. This unit of inductance is called Henry. So if value is given in the Henry, that means you have to know the inductor value is given, not a inductance value is there. So we have to convert this inductor value with inductance. So that inductance is represented by XL, that is called 2 pi F into L. So I hope you got this point. What is the difference between inductor and inductance? So this inductance is called XL, that is represented by 2 pi F into L, and F is called frequency. What did XL is called frequency. Now if I'm talking about capacitance, so capacitance is denoted by XC, and the value of XC equal to 1 upon 2 pi F into C. And here F is called frequency. So can you tell me what is the common thing in RLC? No, there is no any common things between RNL and RNC. But there is one common thing in case of L and C. Means whenever we are calculating XL, that the value of inductance and value of capacitance, so frequency is the common term. Frequency is the common term, means in case of inductance, frequency directly proportional to the frequency. In case of capacitance, frequency is inversely proportional. Means in case of inductor and capacitor, we are having frequency, but in case of resistor, we are not required any frequency. Now I want to ask one question from you guys. Tell me one by one what to give the answer. If I apply this inductor and capacitor in case of DC circuit, what will happen? Suppose this is a resistor, inductor and capacitor. This is a representation of resistor, this is a representation of inductor, and this is a representation of capacitor. And if positive and negative terminal is given, means one terminal is small and one terminal is large, that is called voltage source. Got it, everyone? If one terminal is positive, means large, one is small, voltage source. And if two parallel lines are there with the same length, that is the representation of capacitor. This is the zigzag motion, that is called resistor. And if it is a rounded, that means make in the terms of coil, that is called inductance. Now tell me one by one, if I connect, suppose this is a voltage source and I connect with this resistance. If we are having one voltage source and I'm connecting with the inductor, and if I am having a voltage source and I connect with the capacitor. Is a voltage source everywhere, and here we have L and C. Tell me what will happen in case of inductor and case of capacitor. Who will tell me? Tell me.
Sir, if XL is greater than XC, then it will be called inductive circuit. And if XC is greater than XL, it will be called capacitive circuit. If both is same, then there will be resonance.
No, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Very good. But what I'm asking, listen the question carefully. I'm not asking about which type of circuit you will get, either resistive circuit or inductive circuit. Look the diagram, what I made. Look the diagram first, what I made. I am not connecting inductor and capacitor in the same time. I'm asking if I connect this inductor, if I'm connecting this inductor, one second. I have to change the color first. What I'm asking, suppose I am connecting this inductor with this voltage source and capacitor with this voltage source, what will happen with this? That I'm asking, individually I'm asking, I'm not asking the resonance condition. Now tell me, what will happen with this inductor? Who will tell me, Will you tell me?
Initially inductor mein jaise current oppose karega to uska flux aur usko
who is that tell me Pribesh batao pehle kaun kaun reply kar raha tell me
sir hello
yeah tell me I'm listening yeah it's audible to me
Sir, initially when the current will increase, inductor will try to oppose the current by back EMF, inducing back current.
Okay, listen, the concept you that is good, but look the question. You are talking about the current, that means inductor will oppose the current. Yeah, of course, inductor is always oppose the sudden change of current and capacitor is always oppose sudden change of voltage. That's true. But where it will happen? Where it is happening, where you are having a single phase AC supply or three phase AC supply. But I am told you, here I am talking about DC circuit. It is not an AC circuit, nah? If it is not an AC circuit, that means your frequency is zero. Dear, your frequency is zero. Because in case of DC supply, what is the difference? If I ask you, what is the basic difference between DC and AC? So there is only one difference is there. In case of DC supply, our frequency is zero. That's why it is called constant supply. DC supply is always called constant supply because frequency is zero. Look in this particular case, if I put frequency zero in case of XL, what will happen? I will get XL equal to zero. If I put frequency equal to zero in this particular case, so I will get XC equal to infinite. You got the concept?
Yes, sir, I got it.
Yes. So look, if I'm using inductor and capacitor in case of DC supply, what is going to happen? Because in DC supply, we don't have any frequency. That means our inductance value will become zero. And what is the meaning of that value of resistance is zero? Inductance means you can consider as a resistance, no problem. So if inductance value is zero, that means it is a short circuit. अगर वैल्यू रेजिस्टेंस का जीरो हो जाता है रिएक्टेंस जीरो हो जाता है उसको शॉर्ट सर्किट बोला जाता है दैट मींस इफ यू आर यूजिंग एनी इंडक्टर इन केस ऑफ डीसी सप्लाई व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन योर इंडक्टर इज गोइंग टू शॉर्ट ये आपका इंडक्टर अगर डीसी सप्लाई में मैंने लगा दिया तो क्या होगा ये शॉर्ट सर्किट हो जाएगा And if we are talking about capacitance, we are getting infinite. And where we are getting infinite resistance, that means it is an open circuit. That means it is a open circuit. Guys, you have to know the concept because basic electrical engineering is not beyond the concepts. Whatever you learn doesn't matter if you are not able to get the concepts. Okay. Okay, so that's why I'm explaining. These are the prerequisites. You have to know all the things very well before starting the lecture, and we are not having much time that I will explain each and every thing which is not in the syllabus, but I will give some hint to you what is the important thing. Got it, everyone? I hope this concept is clear to you, that if we are using inductor and capacitor in case of DC supply, it will not work, because inductor will behave like a short circuit and capacitor will behave like a open circuit. Okay, that's why in case of DC circuit, what we are going to read about? Resistance only. Only resistance. Resistance only in case of DC. कहीं पर भी डीसी में हम लोग इंडक्टर और कैपेसिटर को नहीं देखेंगे. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू यूज एनीवेयर इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर इन केस ऑफ डीसी सप्लाई, क्योंकि यूज करने का फायदा ही क्या है. इफ वी आर यूजिंग इंडक्टर एनीवेयर इन अ डीसी सप्लाई, इट विल बिहेव लाइक अ शॉर्ट सर्किट, एंड कैपेसिटर दैट विल बिहेव लाइक अ ओपन सर्किट. देयर इज नो यूज ऑफ इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर इन केस ऑफ डीसी सप्लाई. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर नॉट यूजिंग एट ऑल. गॉट इट एवरीवन? यस. I am moving for our next concept, that is a series and parallel. Students, I will take 5 or 10 more minutes, 5 minutes at least, because we already lagging the time in between of the lecture, we lose some time. Okay, so I'm going to explain a series and parallel connection, which is very, very important to you, because abhi aapko lagta hoga.
Thank you.